Okay, he made it back. He's back here on the far left. He made it.
John Paul Jones achieved upon the high seas in the War of Independence had to be repurchased by Commodore Perry on Lake Erie in the War of 1812. The prestige of Admiral Dewey's victory at Manila Bay in 1898 was re-won by the naval battles in the seas about the far distant islands of the Pacific after the sneak of attacks upon Pearl Harbor and Manila in 1941 had summoned our country to assume its role in World War II. What our chiefs achieved under the Stars and Stripes at Chateau Thierry in Flanders in World War I, their sons were required to repurchase in World War II in the bloody trek across Northern Africa, on the beachheads of Europe, and in the Battle of the Bulge. The flag our American men raised at Iwo Jima was the same flag later raised in the defense of Incheon, Busan, and Pork Chop Hill in far-off Korea. Then another generation, under the same flag, bled to stem the threat of communism in far-off Vietnam. Our young people were once again called to carry our flag in the defense of a free world in the actions of Grenada and Panama. Willingly, our brave men and women carried our flag and the honor of the American people into battle in Operation Desert Storm. The greatest significance of this flag, however, lies in the influence it has in the hearts and minds of millions of people. It has waved over the unparalleled progress of a nation in developing democratic institutions, scientific and technological knowledge, education, and culture. It has served as a beacon for millions of poor and oppressed refugees abroad and stands as a promise that the underprivileged will not be forgotten. What is the meaning of the flag of the United States? There can never be a definitive answer to that question. There are people in the world who see it as a symbol of imperialism. Others see it as a destiny of the people. But reference to these and similar views of the flag was resolved by Woodrow Wilson when he said, "This flag, which we honor and under which we serve, is the emblem of our unity, our power, our thought and shape of this nation. It has no other character than that which we give it from generation to generation. The choices are ours. Only love, true love for our fellow men, can create peace. The emblem and token of that love is the stars and stripes, the symbol of the American way of life. Our fathers, God to thee, author of liberty, to thee we sing. Long may our land be bright with freedom's holy light. Protect us by thy might, great God, our King."
Brothers and sisters, Esquire, how shall we further honor our flag?
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
do the voting of the flag. The flag folding ceremony represents the same religious principles on which our great country was founded. The portion of the flag denoting honor is the canton of blue containing the stars representing states our veterans served in uniform. The canton field of blue dresses from left to right and is inverted only when draped as a pall on the casket of a veteran who has served our country honorably in uniform. In the United States Armed Forces, at the ceremony of retreat, the flag is lowered, folded in triangle fold, and kept under watch throughout the night as a tribute to our nation's honored dead. The next morning, it is brought out, and at the ceremony of reveille, runs aloft as a symbol of our belief in the resurrection of the body. The first fold of our flag is a symbol of life. Is a symbol of our belief in eternal life. The third fold is made in honor and remembrance of the veteran departing our ranks and who gave a portion of his or her life for the defense of our country to attain peace throughout the world. The fourth fold represents our weaker nature as American citizens trusting in God. It is to him we turn in times of peace, as well as in times of war, for his divine guidance. The fifth fold is the tribute to our country, or in the words of Stephen Decatur, our country in dealing with other countries may she always be right, but it is still our country, right or wrong. The sixth fold is for where our hearts lie. It is with our heart that we pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The seventh fold is a tribute to our armed forces, for it is through the armed forces that we protect our country and our flag against all enemies, whether they be found within or without the boundaries of our republic. The eighth fold is a tribute to the one who entered into the valley of the shadow of death, that we might see the light of day and to honor our mother, for whom it flies on Mother's Day. The ninth fold is a tribute to womanhood, for it has been through their faith, love, loyalty, and devotion that the character of men and women who have made this country great have been molded. The tenth fold is a tribute to Father, for he too has given his sons and daughters for the defense of our country since he or she was first born. The 11th fold, in the eyes of Hebrew citizens, represents the lower portion of the seal of King David and King Solomon and glorifies in their eyes the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The 12th fold, in the eyes of a Christian citizen, represents an emblem of eternity and glorifies in their eyes God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. When the flag is completely folded, the stars are uppermost, reminding us of our national motto, In God We Trust. After the flag has been completely folded and tucked in, it has the appearance of a cocked hat, ever reminding us of the soldiers who served under General George Washington and the sailors and Marines served under Captain John Paul Jones and were followed by their comrades and shipmates in the U.S. Armed Forces, preserving for us the rights, privileges, and freedoms that we enjoy today. The Crown City Chorus will sing a military medley.
rolling along
from the
halls of Montezuma to the hills of Tripoli. There are signs of country's battles, brothers there on land and sea. There are signs of life and freedom, and you take part while we're striving. And I'm glad to be the title of United States Marine. Three.